Hello and welcome to ITC Tech Share. I'm Tom Grissom. Today I would like to show you some of the different on-screen keyboard options available on the Surface Pro. So to begin with, let's go to the desktop. Click on the desktop icon and you will notice at the very bottom along the taskbar there is an icon that is a touch keyboard. If you click on that icon, that will bring up a touch style keyboard and you have three different choices. The first choice, which is what I use 90% of the time, is what I call the standard layout, just letters of the alphabet. You do have a caps lock key, which is this up arrow key over here to give you all capital letters. Press it again, it brings it back to small letters. Many times you do need to use numbers and special characters. So if you click the ampersand 123 button, probably the two most used are the at symbol and the slash symbol for a lot of the web work that I do. If I press the ampersand 123 button again, it's a toggle button. So it will take me back to the standard layout. The second style of keyboard is what I call the thumb style keyboard. This is for you thumb typists out there. If you grab the tablet, which 90% of the time I use it on in a landscape mode, so this allows you to reach from the right side and the left side because it's very difficult to reach all the way to the middle of the Surface tablet because it's so wide. So for you thumb typists, that's an option for you. I hardly ever use this one. The third option, which I do sometimes use, is the handwriting recognition one. So with the digital stylus, the pen input that comes with the Surface Pro. Let me close out this keyboard. Let's open up Microsoft Word just to do a quick demo. It's the best way to show you here. So let's open up a blank document. Let's make this a little bit larger so you can see as I type. So the cursor setting here blinking. If I have the keyboard on there, of course, I can just start typing away, but I don't. It's detached right now. So I'm going to bring up my touchscreen keyboard and let's just do the traditional way. Let's go back to the first choice here and just start typing. This is a test. Okay. And I've got a backspace key here so I can backspace that out. So that's the first way. Normally what I do if I don't have a physical keyboard, but just to show you that it does do handwriting recognition, let's do the, I'm going to skip the thumb keyboard. Let's do the third option here, which is handwriting. So if I print letters, so let's do this is a test. It will recognize my handwriting. And if that's what I want, if that's correct, I can just simply say insert. Press enter, that will take me down another line. And let's go out here and do T-E-S-T-N-G. Misspell that on purpose. And it automatically, I was close enough that it automatically did autocorrect. So if that was not what I wanted, it does support strikethrough. So let's say that I didn't want to put the word testing. I can strike that out and just say test. Okay, I don't want that. Let's see if it will recognize cursive handwriting here. This is a test. And you can see it does a very good job with that. It really does a pretty good job of recognizing both my printed and handwritten letters. So I usually change this back to the standard style keyboard because that's what I use 90% of the time. Now this is on the desktop side of things. So let's go down to this little keyboard icon in the lower right hand corner. And this is the hide. So I don't want this. So let's hide the on-screen keyboard. I'm done with Word. So let's close this out. I don't need to save that. And let's just jump back to the start menu and show you another demonstration on the modern side. Let's say I want to go out to the weather and I want to add a new place. So right now it's Charleston, Illinois, 28 degrees. Let's add a city. Since I don't have a keyboard attached, the on-screen keyboard automatically pops up. So let's just see what's going on in Orlando. And once again, when I'm done typing, I can hide that keyboard away. Let's say add Orlando. It will go through, do a search. Which Orlando do I want? I want Florida, Orlando, Florida, United States. And it's a balmy 74 degrees. So first day of spring here. Getting a little bit of spring fever here. So let's go back to weather. Whenever I'm done with that, I can close that out. Now, one other screen I want to make you aware of that may get you out of a pinch sometime. If I swipe in from the right-hand side to bring up the charm bar, I'm going to use the search filter. So I'm going to search, and I'm going to search for the word keyboard. And you will see that there is an on-screen keyboard app. And if I select that app, here is a more fully functional keyboard. So one of the things that the normal on-screen keyboards do not have, they don't have all these extra buttons like home, in, page up, page down, insert, print screen, and so forth. And the big one that I sometimes miss whenever I don't have a physical keyboard attached are the function keys. You'll notice in the lower left-hand corner there is an FN key, which represents the function keys. So sometimes you get into a program and it'll say press F10 to do this or that, and if you don't have that available to you, it's hard to press. So just to make you aware of that, press it again and it goes away and gives you the normal keys. The Control, Alt, Shift, Enter, it's more of a traditional physical keyboard layout machine. So there you have it, the four different on-screen options. So let's just jump back here to the start screen. And until next time, this is Tom Grissom. Keep on learning.